2020 was a very interesting year for you and me, but today let's talk about me. Hi, I'm Dill, and I make videos about living intentionally. Was a very transformative year for me. At the start of the year, I moved into my own apartment, living alone for the first time. And a few weeks later, quarantine happened and self-isolation happened. And it really forced me to be alone with my thoughts and get to know myself better. And I can honestly say that there are some good lessons that I learned in 2020. Number one, the whole future lies in uncertainty. Live immediately. This quote by Seneca, a Stoic philosopher, basically sums up exactly what I want to say here. I can honestly say that I had a lot of plans for 2020, things I was going to go do, places I was going to go see, but COVID came and showed all our plans the middle finger, didn't it? It really was a wake-up call for me though, seeing a lot of young people die from COVID, and it made me realize exactly how I want to be living my life, or rather, how I don't want to be living my life. And I don't want to live my life with the possibility of regretting that I didn't do something that I've been dreaming of doing, but haven't done yet. Like starting this YouTube channel. I finally put together the courage, and I did it. And here we are. Number two. The this is nice trick. Sounds funny, right? So after the lockdowns lifted, and I started going out again and doing things, I kept finding myself thinking to myself, this is nice, over and over again. Like, I'd go to the gas station to get my gas filled, and I'd find myself thinking, this is nice. I'd go to IKEA to do a little shopping, and while I'm in IKEA, I'd find myself thinking to myself, this is nice. Once the gyms opened up and I could go to the gym again, I was definitely thinking, this is nice. Even the first time I drove my car after the lockdown, I found myself thinking, oh, this is nice. I really savored it. And I want to hold on to that feeling. These are all things that didn't necessarily used to excite me before. In fact, they were mundane. So by being in self-isolation, I was able to find a newfound appreciation for tasks like these. Number three, the power of journaling. Journaling is great. Everybody should journal. During 2020, I started journaling regularly, almost every other day, and I'm really glad that I started. There is something about putting my thoughts to paper that allows me to analyze a situation from different perspectives. This has really improved my problem-solving abilities. And over a course of regularly journaling almost every day for a few weeks, I realized that I had a lot more introspection in my life than I used to. Also, journaling has seriously improved my memory. I used to be much, much, much more forgetful. Number four, if it makes me uncomfortable, I have to do it. The thing is, there is always something to gain from putting yourself in an uncomfortable situation, because everything that's worthwhile takes effort and energy and putting yourself out there. For example, if you were trying to learn a new language, it's challenging. It takes a lot of time, it takes a lot of effort and dedication from your side, and you're gonna have to put yourself out there to practice with other people to try and get better. Not being able to freely travel in 2020 made me think about all the trips that I have taken in the past, and I realized that the experiences that I've gained the most out of are the experiences in which I wasn't very comfortable. Like when I've gone backpacking and I didn't have access to hot water for 2 weeks and I had to take cold showers, and it was terrible, but it was great at the same time. It was a lot of fun, it was enjoyable, and made me much more resilient as a person. Additionally, by enduring and experiencing these uncomfortable situations, I get to feel very proud of myself, which is a boost to my self-confidence. I've concluded that if I'm sitting comfortably, something is wrong. I need to make sure that I am never 100% comfortable. That was making me complacent. Number five, cash is queen. I literally had no savings at the start of this pandemic. I had just moved into a new apartment and I had depleted all, literally all of my savings on furniture and decor. This was just 6 weeks before lockdown. So yes, I was crapping myself. You see, I work in an industry that is massively being affected by the pandemic social distancing regulations. So there was a chance that I could lose my job. This was very unsettling. I finally realized the importance of having cash saved up. It gives you peace of mind. And I want a peace of mind too. So I set a goal to save 20% of my paycheck every month moving forward. And I am very proud to say that I haven't wavered from it since. If you're still here with me, thank you so much for watching till the end. To show my appreciation, here is a bonus tip for you. Number six, life isn't serious at all. I used to think life was the serious thing that I had to really, really put in so much effort to excel at. And I always had to be my best and be so ambitious, which isn't wrong. You do, to some level, but not to how far I was taking it. During 2020, I realized, not soon enough, that the purpose of my life is to have the most fun possible, responsibly, by creating new and exciting experiences for myself. For me, that's the answer to a happy and fulfilled life. If you enjoyed this video, click that like button. It really helps me out. And subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like this. Also, I'd like to hear from you guys. Please write in the comments and let me know what experiences and takeaways that you've had from 2020. Thanks for watching. Bye.